this season's going along pretty well, but we're not overly wet. You might not think that by looking at the crop. It's more about the timing of rainfall, and I'm only just touching decile 5 now, which is, you know, something I haven't seen for 3 years out here. So decile 5 is that only average, and this is what can happen with an average season if you get it right. Our soil and mineral erosion program is in our fallow phase, which is 15 to 20% of our program, and it's a long fallow, so it's quite a comprehensive amelioration phase. We lime, gypsum, deep plough with a plaza plough, a modified one-way plough to get the lime down, and then we come through and deep rip. We've got acid at the surface and in the subs, but lime just does not move. So for many years we were liming but not seeing the effect in the sub. So we've plough it down now. We do this hopefully just once every 5-10 years, and we plough it down deep as we can, and then we come through and rip. Cover crop is spread to prevent wind erosion so that we can put cover on the crops, and especially if we're following the fallow phase with canola, we need protection for the canola. Cover crops spread out the back of the, just spread out of a spreader, and that's pretty cheap. It's just done after the plaza ploughing has been done onto the plaza ploughed soil, and then we start ripping. Deep ripping commences then. And that'll incorporate the seed into the soil, get the cover, get the strike, and we're away. At the end of the season, the cover crop is sprayed out. That's determined on ryegrass seed set or wild radish seed set. So before that happens, we'll spray that cover crop out. Canola fits into our rotation after the fallow. It's probably the only place it really fits in at the moment after a fallow, because of the stored moisture, or the moisture that canola needs. We're looking at following legumes with a canola. They do pretty well after the legume. We're just trying to find the best legume at the moment, but that's where that fits in after the fallow. Canola's sown as early as possible to beat the heat. Heat is always a factor out here. Like going into mid-August, late August and early September, we can get some heat. So we go as early as possible to beat that. So that'll be late March, mid to late March, early April preferably. But we go as early as possible to beat the heat. So here's some nice big cabbages down here, all full of goodies that are gonna help fill those pods. Early vigour is really important for yield, and if I can grow cabbages, well, I know that I've got half a chance of growing a decent canola crop. So very important that we get our canola crop established early and up and running. I think the cover crop really gives us that extra N that canola needs, you know, for the higher yield and the vigour. Generally, the canola that I grow out here in the eastern wheat belt has been an open pollinated TT canola, but we're now, after doing quite a few years of in paddock research and trials and measuring the differences with the Roundup Readies and the other hybrids out there, we're sort of growing a lot more hybrid canola. It is very tough in those tough conditions, and we've found that they do stand up and stack up to be a successful canola crop. Sowing depth of canola is really important, and if I'm chasing moisture at the start of the year, I don't really care if it's a little bit deeper while the soil's warm and wet. If it's not that, we wait, and we will wait for it to dry right out after the fallow. We have quite a bit of moisture there, but we can't go in half wet, half dry. So we're now sowing with a canola boot and putting the seed very, very close to the surface. We're on a 10-inch row spacing, and we try and target around that 20 plants per square metre, but you know, we're happy and safe that at 15 plants we can still grow a very good crop. At those sowing rates and those plant densities, I think we can achieve a very good yield out here in the eastern wheat belt of 2 ton if we have the rainfall. Now, the golden rule for growing canola in the eastern wheat belt is moisture. I think that's really important to follow a fallow, like store your moisture, control your summer weeds, and just keep hold of that moisture. But I am seeing good results after legumes, and I'm thinking that that's probably the second phase there, is to get it in after a legume. It's good that GRDC are out looking at what we're doing on farm and looking at the research that we've done to date. It's very satisfying to see such a beautiful crop when the rain falls at the right time.
Go to the description bar below for the latest information, links, and resources.